Hey, Rob here for QuadraTech.com. Today we're out here in the shop and we're introducing a brand new build series for you guys, Project JK Savannah. Now this Jeep actually belongs to a QuadraTech employee. It's a 2016 Rubicon Unlimited. Now you may remember this Jeep from our tent sale video this year where we installed an AAV 3.5-inch suspension along with a set of fuel wheels and ProComp all-terrain tires. Now we also installed Smittybilt's new Safari style hardtop. Really cool looking hardtop, gives you an extra 6 inches of interior headroom, along with adding those cool looking safari style windows along the top edge. Lets in a lot of extra light and creates a one of a kind looking hardtop. Now we've also previously installed a set of Casey Gravity Pro LED headlights in this Jeep. And today we're gonna be installing a whole host of Smittybilt products on here. Now we've got Smittybilt's SRC Gen 2 front and rear bumpers, along with their tire carrier and their side armor to go on this Jeep, along with a new Smittybilt X2O winch and some Casey Gravity Pro LED fog lights to match those headlights. So let's not waste any time, go ahead and get some things installed. So we've got our SRC Gen 2 bumper mounted up here. Now it's made from a heavy duty 3/16 steel, so it's gonna be a great strong bumper for you. It features a really nice looking wrinkle black powder coat finish. Now it gives you protection all the way out to the end of your fenders, and it features these great slip strips down here that'll give you some extra protection from rocks when you're out on the trail. Now it also has two integrated D-ring tabs welded front and back, so you've got some great strong recovery points, and it's got integrated OEM style fog light mounts. Now, like I mentioned earlier, in place of those factory fogs, we've actually upgraded to a set of Casey Gravity LED fog lights to match our headlights. Now, you've also got a recessed winch mount down here that gives you better airflow through to your radiator. And to go with that, we've got a Smittybilt X2O Gen 2 10,000 comp winch. Now, it features synthetic line and an IP68 waterproof rating. It's got a 10,000 pound capacity, comes with an aluminum Hall style fairlead, and a winch remote that can be used either wired or wirelessly. We're gonna go ahead and finish getting our winch wired up here, get our line spooled on the drum, and we're gonna move on to the rear bumper. So we've gone ahead and got our SRC Gen 2 rear bumper installed now, and just like the front bumper, it's made from 3/16 steel construction, so it's a great heavy duty bumper for you. Now a really nice feature are these integrated slip strips here that help protect the frame horns and the center crossmember section when you're off-road. And it also features two nice integrated backup lights to really help light up the trail behind your Jeep. Now it also has a Class 3 2-inch receiver, as well as two D-ring mounts here for any of your off-road recovery needs. Now the bumper is available with and without a tire carrier. Great thing about it is if you choose the bumper without the tire carrier, you get this great block off plate here that covers the hole that's cut in the bumper. Later on, you can choose to upgrade to the tire carrier and you get a new plate with the hole already cut out. Now we're gonna go ahead and install the tire carrier today. So we're gonna go ahead and get that finished up. Now we finished mounting up our SRC tire carrier onto the bumper here. It integrates really nicely with the tailgate, which makes for an easy one-handed operation to open and close your tailgate without having to fumble around with any additional latches. Now the tire carrier also includes this Rotopax mount. Great place to mount a pair of Rotopax behind the spare tire. Allows you to carry some extra fuel, water, or trail gear along with you. And it also comes with this third brake light mount that reuses the factory third brake light and mounts it high up above the spare tire. Now, since we already have an Alpine backup camera third brake light assembly mounted in the center of our spare tire here, we actually don't need to use this bracket. We're gonna go ahead and get our spare tire installed along with that backup camera brake light unit, and then we're gonna move on to the rocker guards. So as you can see, the SRC side armor installs easily thanks to the one-piece design. It doesn't require any modification or drilling to the body of your Jeep. Now it does require the removal of the factory rock rails if they were installed on your Wrangler. Now it is made from a heavy 1¾ 120 wall tubing and includes these great integrated steps which make it really easy to get in and out of your Jeep. Now Dan, the owner of this Wrangler, stopped by to help me get these installed. He's going to give us a little more insight into why he chose the products that we installed on Project Savannah today, as well as all of his future plans.
So when I first started the build, before I even put any of the bumpers on or the winch, or even the hardtop, first thing I did was a lift kit and wheels and tires. And as most guys know who do any kind of off-roading, that's kind of where you want to start. You need to get the extra ground clearance and you want to get the extra traction that bigger tires provide. When I was flipping through the Quadratec catalog, I saw the Smittybilt Safari hardtop, and that was really the catalyst that got the ideas going. So everything that you see is sort of built off of the hardtop. The old Defender trucks that they used in Africa and Australia, I loved the look of those, and I wanted to capture that feeling in Savannah. I chose the Smittybilt SRC bumpers front and rear for this project. Now, because it's a Safari vehicle, I knew I wanted something that was full width, but I also wanted something that had the look that I was going for. The SRC bumpers are perfect because they have the tubular guards that protect the fender flares, but they're also built off of the XRC bumper, which is a rock crawler design. So for me, having the tubular design really played well into the look of a Safari vehicle, but then having the durability of what the XRC bumper is, that's really what sold it for me. You know, a lot of times you'll be off-road, you'll have some stream crossings, you'll have some heavy rain, you'll have some conditions that you really want your winch to be protected from. And when I first saw the Smittybilt X2O series winches, and I saw that they were IP68 protected, I thought, you know what, that's not only a really good value, but the price point was absolutely perfect. I have a family, so anything I can do to help them out getting in and out of the vehicle is very much appreciated. In this case, I chose the Smittybilt SRC side steps, which act as great as side guards, but they also act really well as a step. And in this case, it matches the bumpers, it completes the look of the vehicle. It was the perfect choice for this project. So I'm not quite done yet with Project JK Savannah. Next up is lighting. We're gonna add a KC Gravity Pro 6 light bar, and we're gonna add some additional lights to the bumpers. We're also gonna add a roof basket and a few other touches here and there.